You want to have a read? Jesus loves you so much, brother. Let me pray. He does love you. He does love you. He can take away your headache as well. Call on the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. Friend, don't run away. Jesus died for you. This is the time we're living in, friends. People are offended at the name of Jesus. Jesus commanded us to go out and preach the good news of the gospel. Many people are offended of that name. Do you know that he's coming back to judge the living and the dead? I want to encourage you today to call upon the name of Jesus. Call upon the Lord and acknowledge him as your Lord and as your Savior. Because Jesus died for your sins so you can receive the free gift of eternal life. Have a nice day, young man. God bless you. Jesus loves you. What I'm giving you is the truth. Read the Bible and believe Jesus, because he died for you and he died for you too, sister. Many people don't want to hear this. They want to keep on living in the world, ignoring, rejecting Jesus. But when they die, they're going to end up in the lake of fire because their sins are not forgiven. Jesus says, come to me as you are. Everyone who calls on the name of Jesus will be saved. God bless. Have a nice day. Young man, there's a lovely gift for you.
Thank you.
God bless you. Young lady, Jesus loves you so much. Take care. You're welcome, love. You're welcome. Beautiful. How are you? You're beautiful. You've got beautiful eyes. Yeah, can I give you a gift? This is the best gift that anyone can ever give you because it's free. And it's about Jesus, our Lord and Savior, who died for us so we can enter the kingdom of heaven. He shed his blood on the cross for our sins. And no one else did it, only Jesus. And the Bible says, for God so loved the whole world that he sent his one and only Son, that everyone who shall call on the name of the Lord shall not perish, but shall receive everlasting eternal life. Hallelujah. He's no respecter of persons. Everyone is included. When he died on the cross, he died for everybody. But a gift is only a gift until you receive it, until you say, Jesus, yes, come into my heart, forgive me of my sins. Lord, help me in my life. Hallelujah. No one else loved us enough that they came from heaven to earth to die for our sins. So I want to encourage you. It doesn't matter what you've done in your life or where you're at in your life today. This is a divine appointment. Jesus is knocking on the door of your heart and he's saying, my precious daughter, I love you. I died for your sins so you can enter my kingdom. And the Lord says, just give me your heart. The Bible says, if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord and that God rose him from the dead, you will be saved. Isn't that a beautiful thing to know? That you might go through storms and trials and tribulations and problems in this life, but Jesus is saying, daughter, I'm your Savior. I love you. I know what you're going through. I'm the one who calmed the storm in the Bible. I can calm every storm in your life. And the Lord says, I am God. Nothing is too hard for me. Just put your faith and trust in